Engine ignition.
Main engine start. On board this unmanned launch in February to resupply the International Space Station are a number of experiments, including some grape juice from Michael David Winery in Lodi.
The owner, he sat next to a gentleman who informed him on an airplane that the International Space Station was taking projects from the private sector. And so the owner of the winery, Michael Phillips, came to the winemaking team and asked us to come up with a project.
The local team had only a few days to submit their idea.
It was a project idea that I had from graduate school of looking at the microbial loads and how they would compare in a fermentation on Earth compared to being up in space.
Space station scientists came by to check out their proposal.
We went over the details with them. They liked it a lot because they're growing food up on the space station. So this kind of fit into having perishable foods up in space. You know, most of the foods that are up there are packaged foods or freeze-dried foods. And this fits into that whole theme of having fresh food up in space.
There is a lot more science involved other than just fermentation and zero gravity. And tasters at the winery were curious while sipping what's drinkable down here now.
I think it's very exciting and it's a wonderful adventure, especially coming from Lodi, California. And it's just, that's awesome.
Probably hoping it'll be out of this world. Maybe they could get it in a bottle.
The winemaker has been told to keep an open mind when the juice returns to Earth.
We were told to expect the unexpected.
For Michael David Winery, being a part of the age-old art of winemaking, rocketing into the space age is exciting.
Ultimately, they would like to populate outer space with people, make it a place where people can live. If this project can provide one small piece of the puzzle, then I feel pretty privileged to be a part of that.
In Lodi, Will Hereford, KCRA 3 News.